Hi everyone, my name is Vice and welcome back to Danganronpa, Trigger Happy Havoc. Now we're nearing the end of the fourth trial. Things are kind of weird. So we've already had Hiro and Togo admit guilt and then be shown innocent. Hina has now admitted guilt, but some stuff's not adding up about her story. She said that she went to get poison from Section C and that's where she spilled the powder.
Yeah? What about it?
And after that, you said you moved from Section C to Section A to get the protein.
Mm-hmm.
But the footprints left at the scene were not moving from Section C to Section A. That contradicts what you just said.
So what the heck happened?
What? Then maybe she moved in some weird direction on purpose to disguise her movements?
No, because she said she didn't notice leaving footprints.
No, that can't be it. Remember what Hina just said?
I was just nervous, so didn't notice I'd left the footprint.
What the? Hina, what's the meaning of this?
Yeah, I'm not understanding.
Well, you lied to us. Plain and simple.
Why would she lie about murdering Sakura?
If you look at the footprints, your movements in the chem lab are obvious. The powder had already been spilled when you came in, and you went straight to Section A. So you never went to Section C. Whatever you did there, it only involved Section A.
So what did she do?
Well, you see...
What the hell? What's going on here?
You said it, dude. I have no idea what's happening.
And the footprints aren't the only problem with her account. Before I explain that part, I'd like to submit some new evidence.
What new evidence?
New evidence? Impossible. There can't be.
Are you sure? After all, you're the one that gave it to me.
Huh?
I did?
It was hidden inside the bottle of poison you gave me. I'm amazed you, of all people, would miss such a vital clue. A truly grave oversight.
Wait, so what's it, Byakuya?
Just say it already! What is it you think you found?
I found this.
A piece of glass.
It had sunk to the bottom of the bottle, and the hidden clue was exposed. Thanks to you ingesting the powder.
What?
I couldn't have solved the mystery without you. So, thank you for that.
Okay, what is happening?
What is it?
Oh, you still don't realize? Well then, Makoto, why don't you explain it, huh?
I don't know!
Fine. If you really do know, explain the meaning of that shard of glass.
Shard of light blue glass Kyoko found in the bottle of poison. I think I remember now, I broke something this shade of blue. Rec room window? I guess.
It's part of the window from the rec room door, right?
So what does that have to do with anything?
The window? The window we broke to get in was light blue, just like that. So I think that must be it.
What is happening?
You're right. It must be. Of course, that leads to another question.
It leads to several questions.
How did a shard of glass from the window get inside this bottle of poison?
What's so strange about that?
A lot of things.
What's strange is that, according to what Hina told us...
Where was it the bottle of poison should have been when I broke the rec room window? According to what Hina told us... Section A...
Oh, the bottle of poison was left on the shelf in the chem lab. That is what you said, right, Hina?
I think I get it now.
And yet, somehow a piece of glass from the rec room window made its way into the bottle.
So afterwards, someone took the bottle and put it back on the chem lab shelf.
Everything Hina told us was a lie?
But why would it... I don't understand why she'd lie.
That bottle of poison most definitely found its way to the rec room. It was there at least until the window got broken. In other words, when the locked room was unlocked, there's no other way to explain the presence of that glass in that bottle.
And then, once the room was opened, the bottle somehow got moved back to the shelf in the chem lab.
Yeah, but who would have moved
it? Meanwhile, the protein can we found at the crime scene was planted there.
I don't get it!
After the locked room was opened. In other words, after Sakura died.
I don't get it.
Wait, hold on. You're moving too fast.
Yes, thank you, actually.
I'll grant you, the bottle of poison may well have been in the rec room when it was locked, but how can you say the protein can was put there after the room was unlocked? We already know she was given the protein can with the poison inside, right?
Maybe.
If the can wasn't there when she died, how did she get poisoned?
You're right. We do need to explain that.
I'm very confused right now.
But before we do, there's something I'd like to confirm with everyone here.
Huh?
It has to do with the protein can.
Okay.
After Sakura's body was discovered, did anyone move it or trip over it or anything like that?
I don't think
what
I did.
What are you talking about? Is this some kind of loaded question?
Not at all. Just answer to the best of your ability.
Well, no, not that I remember.
Yeah, me either.
Okay.
Not me.
Yeah, me either.
Okay then, that settles it.
Why did Hina lie?
That proves that the protein can found its way to the murder scene after the room was opened.
Huh?
Oh, come on! How can you say that? How can you know what I don't know?
Because she's smarter than you? The reason you can say that is because there's evidence. There's proof that someone brought the protein can to the rec room after it was opened. Because it was on top of the glass. I guess that's okay. Okay, it's gonna be empty protein drink.
When it comes to that protein can, there's not a doubt in my mind. Until the locked room was unlocked, it absolutely was not in there.
Okay.
So you're saying someone planted it there after we got the door open?
No. No, that's impossible. It had to have been in there the whole time. It had to be.
It was in there before the rec room was...
There we go. Yes,
no,
first time. Okay, I'm glad I understood that because that could have taken a while.
You remember how there was broken glass scattered all around the room, right?
Yes.
Of course. It came from the window you broke to get in. What about it?
Well, those pieces weren't just scattered around the protein can.
They were under the protein can.
We also found pieces underneath the can.
What?
Wait, so did... Was it Byakuya then?
And this proves it. It shows that the can must have been put down on the floor after the window was broken.
Mm-hmm. My thought was that, like, fell off a chair or something.
So it had to be after we got into the room.
Yep, it was you.
I see. So that's your explanation. Kyoko, earlier when you asked if anyone had moved the can or tripped over it...
If that were the case, that would explain the can being on top of the glass.
So you asked everyone about it to eliminate that possibility right out of the gate.
Of course.
And that's made everything clear, hasn't it?
Not really.
As long as it was a locked room, it only contained the bottle of poison and not the protein can.
Okay.
But once the room was opened up, they were switched. And as a result, the protein can wound up in the rec room and the bottle of poison returned to the chem lab.
So why were Hina's footprints there? Because she just stayed in that room.
If that's all true, then why did Sakura drink the poison? I thought we all agreed she was tricked into drinking it because of the protein can.
No, that's not why. The only explanation is she drank it from its original bottle, knowing exactly what it was.
Wait, she committed suicide?
Precisely. She was alone in a locked room. All she had was the poison. What other possibility is there?
Why would she kill herself?
You're saying she drank it, knowing what it was? Such a ridiculous fiction is...
Exactly what happened.
What?
Then tell us already. Sorry. Please, tell us.
Before we get to that, we need to clarify one other thing. We need to establish who exactly got the poison from the chem lab and took it to the rec room.
It was Hina, right? She took it and gave it to Ogre.
What do you think, Makoto?
The one who got the poison from Chem Lab and brought it to the rec room, it had to have been... Hina? That's right, I killed Sakura. Me, I'm the Blackened. What does it matter who got it from where I took it wherever? Let's hurry up and vote and get this over with. I don't know. The one who got the poison is... Sakura?
I got it! I think it was Sakura herself.
I don't get it!
Huh? So Sakura, who was apparently murdered, just poisoned herself? What are you talking about? There's no way!
On the contrary, we know for a fact she went to the chem lab, right to the section full of poisons.
How do we know that?
You're lying! Stop lying! Why? Why would you lie like that?
No, it's not a lie. Sakura definitely went to Section C. Kyoko already showed me the evidence I need. Now I have to hit Hina with it. I have to make her accept it. I don't get it. Crap, not another one of these.
You're a liar! What are you saying?
Wrong!
You're wrong! I'm telling you, I did it! Stop talking!
Okay,
hello. Go on. You're a liar!
Tab.
Wrong! You're wrong! Wrong! You're wrong!
Got it, okay.
I hate you!
Well, that's a mean thing to say, don't you think?
You're a liar! What are you saying? Wrong! You're wrong! I'm telling you, I did it! Stop talking! You're a liar! Wrong! You're wrong! Wrong! You're wrong! You're wrong!
Do you have any kind of proof Sakura took the poison?
This should prove it.
The yellow powder? Oh! It got on her feet because she walked in it.
Did you know that Sakura's foot had a certain yellow powder stuck to it?
It did?
It did. The same yellow powder that had been spilled by the shelf in the chem lab.
Mm-hmm.
That powder was yellow, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So the powder we found on Sakura, what else could it be but the powder from the chem lab?
Okay.
Wait. So what was that powder doing on Ogre's foot?
I'm not sure I understand.
And it was only on her instep, right?
So did she kill herself?
Sakura must have been standing right there where the powder was spilled. So the person who spilled the powder by the shelf wasn't Hina, but Sakura.
Was Hina trying to cover up that she killed herself?
And when Sakura dropped the bottle, she dropped it away from where she was actually standing, which is how she was able to avoid getting it all over herself. But the powder still got scattered around, and some of it must have wound up on her instep. Is there any problem with my thinking?
But why did Sakura pay a visit to Section C in the first place?
I have no
the
idea.
The only explanation is that she was looking for poison. After all, that's all that section contained.
No! It was me! The poison! Because I killed her!
No, you didn't kill her.
The one that killed Sakura. The connection between Sakura and the poison, the unsolved mystery of the locked room, is only one way to explain it.
Here's my answer!
She killed herself?
The one who killed Sakura was Sakura herself.
What? The killer was Sakura?
Wait, so you're saying it was suicide?
Yeah.
I don't believe it. I don't believe it any more than I believe I can fly.
I can't believe it either. Or rather, I don't want to believe it.
But why?
But when you really think about it, everything matches up.
Why would she kill
Sakura
herself?
Sakura went and got the poison. She barricaded herself in a room, and she drank it, all so she could end her own life. And that explains why we couldn't solve the mystery of the locked room.
Because of course, Sakura wanted to create the locked room.
The locked room mystery was created by Sakura.
I'm sure she locked herself in so nobody could stop her from doing what she did.
Mm-hmm.
She sat there, drank the poison, and breathed her last breath. And the empty bottle of poison rolled around the locked room until we came and opened it. At that point, someone grabbed the bottle and snuck it out of the room. And that was you, wasn't it, Hina? You did it to throw off the investigation, didn't you?
Yeah.
When we found her body, you stayed right there near the door. Because you already knew Sakura was dead. And because the bottle of poison had rolled near the doorway.
That's when you picked up the bottle, right? I was too shocked to notice anything. And Kyoko was busy checking the body.
And the more I think about it, the more I realize how unusual your actions were.
I have to go get them. I have to go get the others. And Shaky likes Hina left the rec room.
You said you were going to go get everyone else, but your real intention was to go to the chem lab and switch out the containers, wasn't it? Once you were at the chem lab, you headed straight to the section where the protein powder was kept. There, you took the powder and poured it into the bottle of poison you'd grabbed from the rec room. When you left the lab, all you had was the empty protein can. Thinking about it like that, the footprints make perfect sense.
When you were done, you gathered everyone together. And once you were back in the rec room...
I got everyone. Ogre? Oh, so she's dead, huh? Sakura's been killed, I see.
While everyone else was focused on Sakura, you quietly placed the can on the ground. Honestly, I should have noticed. You should have been the first one to run up to Sakura's lifeless body. The Hina I know never would have left her side in a situation like that.
So, Sakura committed suicide. In order to hide this fact, Hina undertook a series of actions to undermine the investigation. As long as you could disguise the truth, you didn't care if we blamed you for her death. That's why you didn't bother to get rid of such obvious evidence, right? The footprints in the powder and the bottle of poison? Vital pieces of evidence. And yet...
So you're saying Hina consciously deceived us to make it look like she killed Sakura?
Dang.
No! I killed her! I did it!
That's enough, Hina. It's over.
Dang.
It's not! Nothing's over!
It is. Actually, no. You're right.
What?
We have to end this properly.
Oh. Okay. So, let's see here. What the? Not... What? Oh, okay, I see what that is, I see. This is Byakuya reading the note. And then, okay, she hid in there. And then... Watching. Oh, hello, here's Candy. And... He broke over her head. So where is the breaking over her head? No, he didn't use the knight, he didn't use the queen. Ah, here we go. And then he wrote Toko and ran away. Toko left. Saw the note and put it up. Put it on upside down. And then fainted, came Genocide Jill, and where is it? Smashed the queen bottle over her, and then she grabbed Kim C9, they found her dead body. Hina found the bottle and grabbed it. I guess that. I think that's how it goes.
Here's exactly what happened.
I hope.
This case began when Sakura asked a number of people to meet her in the rec room.
Sweet.
Specifically, those people were Hiro, Toko, and Byakuya. But one of them headed out a bit earlier than the others. Toko. She got there one step ahead of everyone else and looked around for a good hiding spot. And she found it. She crawled into the locker to get out of sight. Then, from inside the locker, she saw Sakura enter the room. Next to arrive was Hiro. When he got there, he mistakenly thought Sakura was going to try to kill him, so he panicked.
Yes.
Without thinking, he grabbed a nearby Monokuma box and attacked Sakura with it.
Like, it's easy to recall everything that happened, but sometimes the pictures they give you can be confusing.
Thinking he killed her, he hastily began covering up his crime. He took a magazine from the table and forged a dying message from Sakura. Mm-hmm. To that end, he wrote down a name. Toko. By writing her name, he was hoping to pin the murder on her. But of course, Toko had witnessed the whole thing. So as soon as the coast was clear, she jumped out of the locker and hid the magazine on the shelf with all the others.
I didn't notice it was upside down.
But in her rush, she made one little mistake. She put the magazine back upside down. Soon after, she watched as Sakura slowly opened her eyes. She also saw the blood dripping off Sakura's head and fainted. This caused her personality to switch back over to Genocide Jack. When she woke back up, her second personality also saw the blood-soaked Sakura, and she freaked out.
Yes.
And just like Hiro, she grabbed another Monokuma bottle and attacked her. This explains why there were two wounds on Sakura's head. Assuming Sakura really was dead this time, she set about disposing of the evidence. She gathered up the broken Monokuma bottle shards and the queen chess piece. And that explains how Sakura was attacked twice with the same type of weapon.
Okay, here's where my confidence sort of goes away a bit.
But even after those two blows, she was still alive. So then, what was Sakura's actual cause of death?
Ah, didn't let my reason right. Okay. I think I know where I went wrong. Okay. So, full bottle of Kim C9, and here Hina took the empty bottle. I should have paid closer attention.
Here's exactly what happened. And that explains how Sakura was. But even after those two blows, she was still alive. So then, what was Sakura's actual cause of death? It was the poison that Sakura herself got from the chem lab. She turned the rec room into a true locked room scenario, and then drank the deadly mixture. And there, she took her final breath. Later on, the rest of us discovered that her body was in there. We had to smash the door's window to get inside. But someone already knew what had happened. Knew that she had committed suicide. And that same someone quietly snatched the bottle of poison from off the ground. And while nobody was looking, replaced it with an empty protein can. They did all this specifically to place all the suspicion on themselves in an attempt to guide the trial to a false conclusion. And the one who went to all that effort? It's you, Hina.
Dang.
That's the full truth of the case. Sakura took her own life. And you claim to be the killer to hide that fact. Isn't that right?
I definitely was not expecting this.
That's what happened? But, Makoto, how did you manage to... How were you able to uncover the truth that even I couldn't discern?
Huh? Oh, well, I mean...
You still haven't realized? We don't all act according to calculations and cost-benefit diagrams. That's what makes us so complicated. That's what you don't understand. And that's why you couldn't solve this case. See? Didn't I tell you? When you dismiss other people's feelings, it'll always come back to bite you in the end.
Dang. At least I got an A on this, but, it was like a pretty hollow.
Okay. I think we can all agree you made your point. Did you guys forget already? You still haven't voted yet.
Can you vote for a dead person?
Oh, yeah. That's right.
You seriously forgot? I can feel my energy draining out of me. Well, whatever. You don't really have a choice anyway. You just gotta do it. Maybe you don't want to, but please grab your lever and cast your vote. So, who will be chosen as the blackened? Will you make the right choice or the dreadfully wrong one? What's it gonna be? What's it gonna be?
So I'm guessing I was gonna vote Sakura? Yep. So no execution this time, at least. Dang.
Okay.
Yeah, that's right. The one who killed Sakura was Sakura herself.
My entire existence!
Okay, we're done here.
What did you say?
So that's the whole truth, huh? I see. But there's still one thing I don't understand.
Come on!
Hina, why did you try to cover up what happened? If the truth hadn't come to light, you would have died along with the rest of us.
What are you thinking?
And yet you... Why did you do that?
Don't be mean!
Yeah, we almost died there.
What is this?
Because... That's exactly what I wanted. What? I mean, the reason Sakura died... is because all of you pushed her into a corner. You all killed her. So that's why...
You should have been the one to die!
I couldn't let her be the only one that died.
What?
You don't mean... You're gonna take us all with you? We have to atone for our sins. Because everyone, even me... We all killed her. We all have to pay our crimes.
What?
For serious, that's...
What is this?
You still don't understand? Then let me explain. Do you realize just how much despair Sakura was carrying with her when she died? Look at this. Such brutality has made me desperate. So instead of just waiting to be killed, I'll do it by my own hand. I found it on the ground in front of the rec room. It's Sakura's suicide note. Suicide note. Thinking back, I should have seen it coming. It was right after Genocide Jack had attacked me. Sakura got mad and stormed out of the nurse's office. I ran out after her and... Sakura, calm down. You don't have to worry about me. I'm fine. I can't calm down. I don't care if I suffer for this. It's my fault, after all. But now you're suffering because of me.
No forgiveness!
You tried to protect me, but because of me...
I can't forgive this!
My closest friend got hurt. Sakura...
I...
Because of me, my friends are all going to kill each other. This is all my responsibility. Sakura... thought she was responsible. She thought everything was her fault. Which is why she wanted to find some way to get everyone to forgive her. She asked to meet with them. You asked to meet with those three? You can't. Don't you see how dangerous that is? Don't worry. I just want to talk to them. Talk about what? Listen, don't do it. If they all gang up on you at once, even you...
Hina.
Please don't think of things like that. They're not my enemy.
They're friends.
Sakura. She clearly believed. She completely believed in all of us. If you'd just talked to her, you would have understood. She was a friend to all of us, and yet...
Why?
And yet... You trampled all over her feelings. And then you did the unthinkable. No, that was just a misunderstanding.
What are you saying?
Don't stand there and call it a misunderstanding. She believed in you and you wouldn't even listen to what she had to say. without asking a single question, you tried to kill her?
I forgive you.
Do you have any idea how desperate she was seeing you act like that? That's what her suicide note means. So instead of just waiting to be killed, I'll do it by my own hand. That's how far you pushed her. Sakura, what happened to you?
Hina.
You came. Wait right here, I'll help you out.
Hina.
Huh?
I'm
so glad that I got to meet you. What's wrong, Sakura? Why are you talking like that?
I have a favor to ask.
Huh?
A favor?
Some protein.
Could I ask you to... Yeah, you got it. Just hang on, I'll be right back. That was the last conversation I had with her. I went to the chem lab to get the protein she had asked for. When I got there, I saw the powder. And that's when I realized. I saw that someone had taken something from the poison shelf. Sakura. So I ran back to the rec room as fast as I could. But by the time I got there, it was already too late. Sakura.
Please!
Let me in. Please open the door.
Why? Why?
Why did she have to die? She had weaknesses, just like any other person. She got cut, she bled. If someone hurt her, she felt it. That's weakness. That's normal. And yet...
Why?
You all blamed her. I tried to protect her and I suffered for it. And that just added to the weight she had to carry. And I didn't even realize it. Hina. We killed her. All of us. We pushed her into a corner. And we murdered her.
Why?
People like us shouldn't be allowed to live. And that's why you tried to lead us astray. You did your best to make us arrive at the wrong conclusion during the class trial. Sakura died hating all of us. I wanted to free her of her regrets. But even that got found out. In the end, I wasn't able to do anything for her. I could never face her after this.
Hey!
I'm sorry to interrupt right when you're about to deliver the final tearjerker, but...
Hey!
It's just taking so long, 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 long. I'm about to fall asleep over here. I mean, do you really think you have any idea what Sakura was actually thinking when she died?
What is this?
What did you say?
Hmm.
Everything you said is nothing but your interpretation, right? Your own opinion on what her suicide note meant.
What are you saying?
Of course I knew what she was saying, because her and me...
In other words...
Well, what I'm really trying to say
yes,
is...
Yes, indeed.
Don't you think the entire foundation is shaky? What if it was really like this?
What the heck?
What is that?
Of course!
Isn't it obvious?
Yep.
A suicide note. Sakura's suicide note. But he ain't already...
Bad.
Oh, I wrote that one. It was all me, baby.
It's true.
This is the one Sakura addressed to Hina and put in her room.
Huh?
What? Then you lied to me?
Unbelievable.
Oh, don't say lie. Make it sound so dirty. I just thought I'd liven things up
well
a bit.
Well,
I can't
now,
help
well
it if you
now.
Totally took my little scribbles at face value. Didn't even have Sakura's signature on it. You filthy little... I'm not filthy. I didn't do anything. Did I falsify evidence? Did I affect the outcome of the class trial? The case played out between you and you alone. You were the ones jerking each other around. Heck, even if Bill had factored in, it still would have been between you guys. So what's the problem? This is all part of the production process. Okay, and scene. Cut!
And?
So then, what did she write in her real suicide note?
What are you gonna do?
I'm glad you asked. For your benefit, I shall read it using my melodic, angelic, harmonic narrator voice.
Hey!
Wait, no. Haven't you ever been curious about the whole suicide note thing? Who came up with the idea of leaving a note when you kill yourself in the first place?
But hold on!
Isn't it just so unfortunate? Killing yourself is just so final, you know? You can never hear the rest of their story. And the whole truth is lost in darkness. Gives me the willies.
Enough already.
Could you get on with it, please?
Yes, indeed!
Okay, okay, geez, talk about a buzzkill. Alright, here we go. My good friend Hina, there's something I have to tell you. I hate to do it like this, but you need to know. This is my final wish.
As you know, I've been giving information to the one who's imprisoned you here.
It was our first night at the strange school that the Mastermind came to see me.
The Mastermind took control of my family's dojo and demanded I become their tool.
You might not see the importance of a dojo. My family has watched over it for 300 years.
I couldn't let it be destroyed under my watch. So even if it meant my own life, I had to protect it. That's how I saw things.
However, that was my greatest weakness. Because of that, I made the mistake of giving in to the mastermind.
And what the mastermind wanted from me was nothing less than murder.
They were probably worried that until the first murder had happened, nothing would move forward. But neither the mastermind nor I expected was the incident involving Sayaka. At that point, the plan changed. The mastermind told me to hold off, to wait until we reached another stalemate.
However, as I lived here with all of you, as I lived here with Hina, my resolve began to weaken.
Watching everyone fight with such despair, trying so desperately to stay alive, I saw the weakness in my own heart, the mistake of succumbing to the mastermind, and more than anything,
I cannot betray those who would call me their friend.
That's how I came to feel. So that's why Sakura...
I've made a decision. I will no longer retreat, no longer compromise, no longer regret. I've made my decision. I'm going to resist you.
Of course, because of that, I decided to reveal her secret, which made everyone else hate her. Her decision to stay true to all of you led directly to all of you hating her for it. Ironic, isn't it? Or maybe oxymoronic. Or just moronic.
Of course, I understand if you all hate me. All of this is because of my own weakness.
I'm perfectly willing to accept whatever attack you may want to make on me.
So this is my atonement for betraying you. That's what I had in mind.
But unfortunately, that's not enough. This won't end with me just accepting your hatred.
My own situation has started having an effect on more people than just me. Which is exactly what the mastermind wanted when they revealed my betrayal.
My betrayal brought suspicion, disharmony. The mastermind knew that eventually it would escalate into someone murdering someone else.
Of course, I'm still responsible for that as well.
I have an obligation to get the situation under control. And to fulfill that obligation, I've decided to do as the mastermind has commanded. I will do as I was told and commit murder.
But I've decided the one I'm going to kill is myself.
If the mastermind demands to kill someone, then that someone will be me. Then my dojo will be safe, and above all else, none of you will have to kill anyone. When I die, the source of conflict among you all dies with me. For that, I'm willing to give up my life.
If it can save you, then sacrificing my own life could have no greater meaning. Whatever you think of me, please know that you are all my most treasured friends.
I've never had people like you in my life.
Huh?
Then Sakura didn't feel cornered. She didn't die hating
us. No way!
She wanted to stop us from fighting, to protect us.
Correct.
She didn't end her own life because she was weak. Quite the opposite, in fact. She was strong. Too strong. That's why she killed herself. She chose death for herself in order to protect the rest of us. To sacrifice so much. No normal person could do that.
However,
it was only her limitless strength that made it possible.
Finally, Hina, I want to apologize to you especially.
The reason I didn't tell you any of this, is because I knew you would try to stop me. I'm really, truly sorry. But please don't be sad. If I can thwart the mastermind's plans, if I can keep you from killing each other, that's enough for me. This is the path I have chosen. This is the only way I have left to distinguish myself. And you can use this note to bring the class trial to a quick end. I'm so sorry to ask you to do something so unpleasant, but I have to leave the rest to you. Please talk to Byakuya, Toko, and Hiro on my behalf. I can't tell anyone about my plan while I'm alive, but I wanted you to understand why I'm doing this. In the end, though, I hope to show myself through actions and not words. Hopefully, then they'll see.
I never saw you as my enemy. You were only ever my friend, who I wanted to help as much as possible. Hina, whatever it takes, survive. Survive along with everyone else. No matter what, just survive.
But...
This is... I didn't understand how she felt. Not at all. I thought we were close and still...
What are you gonna do?
But in the end, all her meddling was, like, totally pointless.
Oh.
She died so you guys wouldn't try to kill each other. But you almost ended up doing it anyway. Thanks to you, her death had no purpose at all. In fact, it was because of her stupid meddling that the rest of you nearly bit the big one.
Too bad!
She deserves all the blame. Everyone blame her. Go ahead. She deserves it. No, it was you. You are the one who made the fake note. You are the one who threw everyone off. If that note had been there from the beginning... No, Hina might have still tried to cover it up. Now then, the next victim has been decided. What do you mean, next victim? Nobody here blames anyone. Huh? First of all, you're in the wrong for tricking Hina with that fake suicide note. And plus, Sakura's death wasn't a waste. Because she made us remember. We're not enemies that hate each other. We're friends who need to work together. I'm not friends with Byakuya. He can just... Meh.
You know?
Damn straight. This is all because of our misplaced hatred. Well? I don't blame her. I can't blame her. And nobody can blame Hina either. Blah? Whether or not there is a spy never really mattered. Because the one we need to destroy is you. Nobody else.
What the heck?
That's not how this is supposed to go. But anyway, are you sure about that? This killing game is a competition between all of you, remember?
Hey!
Your enemy is each other. He's absolutely right about that.
Ew.
Ah, lovely Byakuya. You understand, don't you? This is a life or death elimination match. The only way to survive is to win. There can be no doubt that those are the rules of the game. Which is why I'm bowing out of the game.
Naturally.
Sakura and Hina are both willing to sacrifice their own lives to deny the reality of the game. Thanks to them, it would appear the others have cast aside their fear for this game.
Don't make me repeat myself.
There's no point in participating in a game which has lost that sense of excitement, which is why I will no longer be participating in it. What's going on here? Now I have only one thing to look forward to.
All clear.
And that is to heap the harshest possible punishment on the next one who thinks they can control me. Byakuya, does this mean... Don't misunderstand. I haven't been moved by some thoughtless sentimentalism, if that's what you're thinking. Wherever Master goes, I go. If the Mastermind turns out to be a guy, maybe I can catch on fire. Everyone.
Hey.
Well, now can you say Sakura's death has no meaning?
Yeah.
How boring. But nothing good can come of this. I'm still going to be the one having the fun time.
What the heck?
The fun time? Anyway, let's go about that good-for-nothing backstabber and get back on track.
You want me to punish you guys?
It's the moment you've all been waiting for. Punishment time. Who are you going to punish?
What?
But Sakura is the killer, right? And she's dead. You're not gonna...
But...
Is it me?
Wrong!
Oh, heavens no. Just because the Black End is dead doesn't mean I can just sub in whatever old student I want. Didn't I tell you? I'm very particular about the bare times one rule.
Listen up!
I've spent so much time preparing my special punishment, it'd be a shame to let it go to waste.
Yahoo!
So, for my special punishment, I prepared a special guest. A special guest.
Let's give it everything we've got! It's punishment time!
What? No. 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 Not you. Not you too, no. 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 suck, man. You turned into a mangled hunk of junk.
Phew.
That really took it out of me. Maybe I'll go grill a plate of chicken. After all, they say for post-workout grub, chicken's where it's at. I'm all about the grilled goodness. Fried, broiled, give me a break. The color, the smell, the succulence, grill is where it's at. I hate you so much.
So?
I realize how dangerous it could be, but still, I have to do this.
But
I'm scared, but I can handle it. I don't really understand why, but
still,
when I think about everyone else, my courage starts to grow. You might think I'm just some inhuman AI, but it's true. So, it's okay.
I'm gonna do my best.
If it's for the sake of everyone else, I won't be afraid. Alter Ego's words raced through my heart and soul, and my disbelief gave way to raw anger. The anger turned to fury, black and muddy and boiling over. It bubbled up through my body, quickly overflowing and shooting out of my mouth. How dare you? That was my friend. How dare you kill him?
What's the matter?
Huh? Your friend's the laptop? That's pretty pathetic. What's next? Friend with a basketball? Shut the hell up. He wasn't just a laptop, he was my friend. And you killed him. Isn't this what you call animism? Where a soul dwells within all things, even, like, laptops? Well, you can call it whatever you like. Bottom line is, it got in my way. I was trying to find things out all sneaky.
Just as I thought.
So you finally noticed him?
Actually!
Finally? No. I knew about him from the very beginning. I knew Chihiro was doing something with the laptop, and I knew you were using it to analyze data.
Yeah!
I knew exactly how it was going to all play out from the start. What?
What are you thinking?
You knew and you were still cocky enough to let us take the plunge?
Yep.
Well, I mean, the data in the laptop, it was, I guess you would call it a gift from me to you.
Phew.
Maybe mark a reward in honor of you being able to unlock something so difficult.
Hey,
So of course I didn't care if you got access to that. But sneaking into the network was just too personal. So I'd do a little, reformatting.
I want to be able to help.
I want to keep being helpful to everyone. I want to work as hard as everyone else so we can all get out of here. Alter Ego wanted to fight for us. He wanted us to help, or he wanted to help. At the risk of his own life, and for that he was killed. Yeah, the punishment time has made me feel a billion times
very
better.
Very nice.
Experiencing a meaningless death is so soothing. It makes me remember that every low can get even lower. No, his death wasn't meaningless either. Everybody who's died so far, the deaths of every one of our friends, they all make us stronger. I swear, someday you will pay for this.
Ba-bum.
Holy moly, you're super mad. Like, just unreasonably upset.
Well?
Okay, time to bring things to a close. Oh, but before
that,
I need to read the postscript.
What?
Postscript?
Yep.
There's still a bit more left of Sakura's note. Do I have your attention? Okay, then here we go. Prepare your ears for the dulcet tones of yours truly. One other thing, Hina. There's something I'd like you to tell the others. Hopefully it was act as a clue to help you unravel the mystery of the school. What? A clue?
Hina.
I've spoken with the Mastermind off and on the whole time I've been here, and so I've learned one thing, which is, the Mastermind has done something to us. I think what they've done is, oopsie daisy, that was a close one. Another word, and we would have been in hip deep in spoiler territory. Okay, I don't want to lose the spy, so book club is dismissed for today. You can't just stop the most important bit. Makes your brain rumble and tumble, huh? Makes you so mad you don't even freaking know, huh?
You guys?
That's the whole point, stupid. Just to get back at all of you for hardening your resolve. Fine, but at least Sakura's note. Like I'd ever let any of you greaseballs have it. But
too bad.
Sucks for you, loser. Wait, what's this?
What
is it now?
What?
There's one last line in the note. And let me just say this to the Mastermind. I'm not gonna just lay down and die. I will fight you, you bastard, no matter what. That's seriously it. Huh. Wow, what a stubborn loser, huh? She won't lie down and die, she'll fight you? Well, whatever. Who cares what some dead musclehead has to say?
Well?
Okay, I'm out of here. You guys should try to get some rest, you know? Maybe take some time to reconsider how you approach this school life of yours. Are you sure you don't want to graduate? Can you really cut free from the regrets of the outside world? Think about that. Think long. Think hard. Those were his parting words to us right before disappearing. But what was that all about? Sakura's final message. Her last clue to help us solve the mystery of the school. The Mastermind did something to us? Kyoko said something about that before, didn't she? It was after Celeste's trial was over.
You...
What did you do? What did you do to my body?
Ooh.
What?
Hey.
Answer me, what did you do to my body? This mastermind did something to our bodies? What are they saying the mastermind did? What did the mastermind do to us? I mean... Did the mastermind plant a bomb on us or something? If we try to leave the school, a sensor goes off and the bomb explodes? I've seen stuff like that in movies or comics. That's not totally unheard of. I'm thinking he altered our memories and that we all used to go to school together and that's where there are pictures. That's what I'm thinking. No, I feel awful just thinking about it. I can't afford to acknowledge thoughts like that.
Yo!
So the class trial's over and Monokuma is gone. So, now what do we do?
Yes.
What else is there other than to head back up?
Oh
yeah. Okay, let's get out of here. But... Hina must still feel responsible. Dial back that ego a bit, girl. The kind of mystery someone like you could pose is absolutely no threat.
Not possible.
I would never have lost to that kind of challenge. What are you talking about? Kyoko and Makoto are the ones who figured everything out.
Stop talking.
Shut up. Seriously. I'm sorry. How many times do you plan to apologize? How about you make that the last one? I haven't reached a point where I need someone apologizing to me more than once.
Sorry.
Okay. I see what you mean. Then... I'll try... That totally wasn't normal, right? Did she just capture his
flag? No, 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 no!
What? I can't serve the existence of someone who had disturbed the romance between me and Master. What are you talking about? That's absolutely not what's happening here. Why would I ever go for a sleazeball like him?
What did you say?
Sleazeball?
What the heck?
That's right, I called you a sleazeball, because you are a sleazeball.
I see.
Apparently you still have a death wish. Oh, more biting sarcasm. No wonder you didn't have any friends.
No, 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 no!
Hey, stop fighting with Master. You're making me jealous. I want the abuse, give and take. Me! I guess it's not so easy for everyone to act like friends. Well, it's just how it is for now. And so... Sakura's class trial came to an end. And we returned to the world of Hope's Peak Academy. But the story wasn't even close to over. Time kept marching on. We went all back to our rooms. And before long, night snuck up on us.
This is a school announcement. It is now 10 p.m. As such, it is officially nighttime. Soon the doors to the dining hall will be locked. An entry at that point is strictly prohibited. Okay then. Sweet dreams, everyone. Good night. Sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite.
That time descended and pulled me down along with it. Down into sleep. I couldn't remember the last time I'd fallen into such a deep sleep. But the night still wasn't over for me. A voice. I could hear a voice. What? Wake up. Wake up. Huh? The voice dragged me from my deep slumber into hazy half-consciousness. My eyelids were like lead. What are you doing in here?
Yes, it's me.
Huh? Kyoko?
I said yes.
Why are you in my room?
Kyoko's here.
Wait, what?
In a flash, I was wide awake. What are you doing
it's
here?
It's true.
I'm here to wake you up. Oh, I see. Wait, but my door. It was unlocked. You're unbelievably careless. It was unlocked? Are you serious?
Hey.
Always. You don't have to overreact like that every time you're surprised. What time
Correct.
Is it? 3 o'clock in the morning, of course. It's 3 a.m.? Why was Kyoko waking me up at this hour? Well, this has already been kind of a longish episode, so I guess I'll have to figure out on the next one, on the next episode, but dang... People were not kidding. That was one hell of a trial. And there's no way that was the last death. There's no way. And so it makes me even... The feels even build up even more, knowing that there still will be another murder. And alter ego even. Anyways... Thank you all so much for watching. If you like what you see, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. It really helps me out a lot. If you have suggestions for other games you need to play, let me know down in the comments. Again, thank you for watching, and I will see you on the next Vice of Virtues. Catch y'all later.